Dear students, welcome to my English literature class. Today we will do unit test preparation for chapter number 1, that is Uncle Potcher Hangs a Picture, and about a poem My Shadow. Now come to this assignment. We will revise the question answers as well as exercises. Before explaining you the question answers, first of all I will give you some summary of the chapter and about the poem. So let's begin with the chapter 1. Let's begin with the first chapter. Students, as I have already told you about the Uncle Potcher, I have given you the detailed information in the previous video about this chapter. So, the Uncle Potcher, he is the main character in the story. He is very funny and hilarious character. Mainly, this story is concerned regarding a picture. Although to hang a picture, it is a very simple task, but he had recruited so many persons to hang a picture on the wall. As per the story, first he sent one girl to bring some nails. Again he sent one boy to tell the size of the nail. Again one person he sent to bring the hammer and stepladder. He sent one girl, her name is Maria, to bring the light. So in this way, whole family was moving here and there in search of things through which the Uncle Potcher has to hang the picture. After collecting all the things, he had started measuring the distance on the wall. He had put the mark on the wall with one hand, and with the other hand he had hold a hammer in his hand. Unfortunately, he fell down and got an injury on his finger. Because he just want to protect the glass of the picture, and he got the injury on his finger. Again the whole family members was around him to get him up. Again he started hanging a picture with the help of the family members, but again Uncle Potcher's bad luck exists, because the hammer fell from his hand. Although he had hung a picture at the end, but whole credit he has taken himself to hang a picture. As per the reality, for completing this simple task, there was a big support of his family. But Uncle Potcher tries to take whole credit for himself, because he thought that only he has done this task. He is the main role model to complete this task. So this is all about the story. Now let's begin with the question answers. Make the list of all the things Uncle Potcher would need to put up a picture on the wall. कौन सी चीजें चाहिए थी अंकल पॉटचर को टू हैंग द पिक्चर ऑन द वॉल? अंकल पॉटचर वुड नीड सम नेल्स, हैमर, अ रूल, स्टेप लैडर, अ किचन चेयर, अ स्पिरिट लेवल, लाइट एंड अ बिट ऑफ पिक्चर कोट टू पुट अप अ पिक्चर ऑन द वॉल. ही रिक्वायर्ड कौन क्या क्या चाहिए था उसको? नेल्स, हैमर, a rule, a step ladder, a kitchen chair, a spirit level, light and a bit of picture code. So all these things are required to hang the picture on the wall. Why would Uncle Potcher spring around the room looking for his handkerchief? Uncle Potcher would spring around the room looking for his handkerchief to tie his finger. He would cut himself टू सेव द ग्लास व्हेन ही वुड ड्रॉप द पिक्चर. अंकल पॉटचर क्यों मूव कर रहा था हेयर एंड देयर एंड व्हाई ही वाज लुकिंग फॉर द हैंकरचीफ, क्यों ढूंढ रहा था अपने हैंकरचीफ को, बिकॉज उसका जो फिंगर था उस पर इंजरी उसको लगी थी उसको, और मतलब उसके फिंगर के ऊपर कट लग गया था, बिकॉज ही वॉज ट्राइंग टू प्रोटेक्ट द ग्लास, तो उसकी वजह से उसके उसकी फिंगर को वो टच कर गया और उसकी फिंगर को कट लग गया. सो ही वॉज टू मच ब्लड वॉज कमिंग फ्रॉम हिज फिंगर एंड ही वॉज ट्राइंग टू फाइंड द हैंकरचीफ फ्रॉम हिज कोट, बट जो कोट था वो उसको मिल नहीं रहा था. फिर उसको क्या हुआ था, याद आया था कि जो उसका कोट है वो वहां पे पड़ा था जहां पे वो पहले बैठा था. Why would all the family members have to go down on their knees? All the family members would have to go down on their knees and grovel for it. Why would all the family members have to go down on their knees? All the family members would have to go down on their knees and grovel for it. उनकी जो family members थे वो इधर उधर अपने hands और knees को move कर रहे थे क्योंकि वो डिफरेंट डिफरेंट जो थिंग्स थी जो पिक्चर को हैंग करने के लिए यूज होती हैं उनको वो सर्च कर रहे थे. When would Uncle Porcher smash his thumb? Uncle Porcher would smash his thumb with the first blow when he would fix the spot and hammer the nail on it. जो अंकल पॉर्चर था उसका थंब क्यों इंजरी हुआ, क्योंकि वो जो अंकल पॉर्चर था वो जब वो फिक्स कर रहा था स्पॉट मतलब मींस वो निशान लगा रहा था जहां पे पिक्चर को हैंग करना है, उस टाइम जो हैमर था उसके नेल के ऊपर लगा था. जो हैमर क्या होता है मैंने आपको बताया था वर्ड मीनिंग्स में भी चैप्टर में भी कि ये एक टूल होता है जिससे पिक्चर को हैंग किया जाता है. तो जो वो हैमर था वो उसके मतलब जो जब वो हैमर से नेल को लगाने लगा वॉल के ऊपर तो वो उसके ऊपर लगा, तो इस वजह से उसकी जो फिंगर थी वो उसमें से ब्लड आ गया और उसको बहुत पेन हुई. हाउ वुड द पिक्चर लुक आफ्टर अंकल पॉटचर हंग इट? द पिक्चर वुड लुक आइदर वेरी क्रूक्ड और इनसिक्योर आफ्टर अंकल पॉटचर हंग इट. जब अंकल पॉटचर ने पिक्चर को लगाया तो वो जो पिक्चर थी वो बहुत ज्यादा इनसिक्योर थी, वो मतलब सेफ नहीं थी. और क्रूक्ड का मीनिंग होता है कि मीन्स वो सही प्लेस पे नहीं थी, इस पर सही जगह पे नहीं थी जब वो लगा रहा था. वट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ डेड बीट? डेड बीट मीन्स एक्सट्रीमली वेरी टायर्ड. डेड बीट का मतलब होता है बहुत ज्यादा थक जाना, टायर्ड हो जाना. एट वट टाइम वॉज द पिक्चर फाइनली पुट अप? कौन से टाइम पे पिक्चर को फिक्स किया गया था? एट द मिड नाइट द पिक्चर फाइनली पुट नाइट पुट अप. मिड नाइट के टाइम में पिक्चर को फाइनली प्लेस कर दिया, हैंग कर दिया वहां पे. हाउ मेनी पीपल वुड हैव टू होल्ड अंकल पॉटचर चेयर? अंकल पॉटचर की चेयर को कितने पीपल ने पकड़ा हुआ था? टू पीपल वुड हैव टू होल्ड अंकल पॉटचर चेयर. हु वुड होल्ड द लाइट? किसने लाइट को पकड़ा हुआ था? मैरिया. मैरिया वुड होल्ड द लाइट. Students, we have discussed about this chapter as well as question answers. Now, I will give you some summary of the poem and then we will discuss about the question answers. So, my shadow poem is written by Robert Louis Stevenson. So, students, this poem is written by Robert Louis Stevenson. The poem describes the excitement of a child who is fascinated by his own shadow. In the first stanza, the poet has used this term to show that the shadow is much like him at every part of the body. It is identical to him in every possible way. See, in this second stanza, the poet describes about the child. He is very fascinated by the shadow. He is surprised by how the shadow grows big and small every day, which he has not seen happening to anyone or anything else around him. He has also described about the India rubber ball. India rubber ball is a soft ball which is used by the children for playing. In the third stanza, the poet describes that the shadow stays close behind him. In the fourth stanza, the poet used the term drew on every buttercup. The poet has used this term to portray the freshness of early morning. This also marks the time when the sun is only now rising in the horizon and there is dew everywhere on leaves and grass. So students, all this is about the poem we have discussed in a short, concise way. Now we will revise the question answers of this poem. Who jumps into the bed first? The shadow jumps into the bed first. Kaun jump karte the pehle? Shadow. Jo shadow thi wo jump karti thi bed pe pehle se. What is so funny about the shadow? The funny thing about the shadow is the way he likes to grow. क्या थी फनी चीज शेडो के बारे में? कि वो जब उसका मन करता था वो ग्रो करती थी, कभी वो बड़ी हो जाती थी, कभी वो छोटी हो जाती थी. What does the poet compare his shadow's growth to? Poet ने किससे compare किया था shadow की growth को? The poet compares his shadow growth to an India रबर बॉल. पोएट ने किसके साथ कंपेयर किया था शेडो को? इंडिया रबर बॉल के साथ. वो मैंने आपको बताया है कि जो इंडिया रबर बॉल होती है वो एक सॉफ्ट बॉल होती है जिससे जो बच्चे हैं वो प्ले करते हैं. सो आई होप ऑल ऑफ दीज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स आई हैव गिवन यू फॉर द यूनिट टेस्ट प्रेपरेशन. रिवाइज ऑल दीज क्वेश्चन आंसर्स. वी विल कवर अवर next part in another video. Thank you. Have a nice day. Dear students, welcome to my English grammar class. Today in this video we will revise unit test preparation. Come to the chapter number 1, that is the sentence. Students, I have already discussed with you this chapter in a detailed form. Now, I will give you some summary of this chapter. As you know that sentence is a group of words that makes complete sense. जो sentence होता है वो group of words होते हैं जिनसे जो complete एक sense बनती है. Group of words से क्या बनती है? Complete sense बनती है. That is a sentence. इसमें क्या होता है? जो words होते हैं वो एक correct order में होते हैं. Or it begins with the capital letters as well as it ends with the full stop, question mark or an exclamation mark. Even isme verb ko bhi use kiya jata hai. Jo hum actions karte hain past, present, future mein, wo jo verbs hoti hain, main verb or auxiliary verbs, wo bhi isme use hoti hain. So as you know that A to Z are alphabetical letters. Letters से क्या बनते हैं? Words बनते हैं. Words से क्या बनता है? Sentence. Sentence से क्या बनते हैं? Paragraphs. So all these things are interrelated with each other. अगर कोई भी word एक proper order में नहीं होएगा, एक proper उसकी सेंस नहीं बनेगी वर्ड्स की, तो वो सेंटेंस इनकम्प्लीट हो जाता है. सो सेंटेंस को कंप्लीट बनाने के लिए जो वर्ड्स हैं उनको प्रॉपर ऑर्डर में किया जाता है ताकि उनकी उनकी जो सेंस है वो एक सही बने, कंप्लीट बने और जो सेंटेंस है वो भी कंप्लीट फॉर्म होए. सो लेट्स बिगिन विद दिस एक्सरसाइज. Rearrange the following groups of words to form meaningful sentences. I read newspaper in the thief been nabbed had the that. So this sentence is not in a proper order. We have to rewrite this sentence and have to give some meaning. इस सेंटेंस का कोई मीनिंग तो बन नहीं रहा, अब हमें इसको रीराइट करना है और इसका इसकी सेंस बनानी है. तो कैसे बनेगा? आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट सेंटेंस बिगेंस विद सब्जेक्ट देन वर्ब देन ऑब्जेक्ट. सो व्हाट इज द फॉर्मूला? सब्जेक्ट प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट, सब्जेक्ट प्लस वर्ब प्लस ऑब्जेक्ट. दीज आर द थ्री बेसिक एसेंशियल थिंग्स यूज्ड इन द sentence. So here subject is I. We have to begin with the subject. I had read in the newspaper that the thief has been nabbed. Again move to the next point. Nightfall began quickers the at the piercing calls. Again here subject is the Crickets. The crickets began their piercing calls at nightfall. Crusoe's ship violently the sea storm rocked the. So here we will begin with the subject. The sea storm violently rocked the Crusoe's ship. Painting painter painstakingly the his worked at. The painter worked at the painting painstakingly. Here subject is the painter. Worked is a verb. Gift free a mother offered school by the was my. So here subject is my mother was offered a free gift by the school. Wore a cap he of cotton made his own head. He wore a cap made of cotton on his head. Parts several tea popular in world there the is very of. Tea is very popular in several parts of the world. So here tea is subject and we have begun with the subject. So now we have rewrite all these sentences in a proper way and it makes the complete sense. So by following this rule, subject plus verb plus object, we have rewrite these sentences in a correct form.